Hi there guys, welcome to another episode of Shenanigames. My name is Ryan and today we are looking at Fallout 4. We're here today in Sanctuary Hills and I just want to give you a tour of my Sanctuary Hills fortress. Now, the reason I'm doing this now is because obviously all the DLC is coming out and because of my mods I'm having various issues with some of them, you know, compatibility issues, load orders and all of that. So I just want to do a clean install of my game basically. But before I do that, I've spent ages on this settlement, putting it together and everything. So I want to show it in case I lose it, basically, in case once I do the fresh install I can't get this save game back. So like I said, we're in Sanctuary Hills. I'm just going to go over here. As you can see, we're pretty well fortified. The wall actually goes all the way around. So we can see a guard just up there as well, and some lovely lights. Oh, and of course, the Minutemen flag. So let's head in. So yeah, pretty epic door. Now, the first thing you'll probably notice is the green grass. This is a mod, I'll leave the link in the description. Now, some people will probably say, like, oh dude, that's so not canon, but I just like the colour, you know, it's just something that's not brown or grey. It's just something a bit different. Also, something I've tried to do throughout this settlement that you'll probably see as we go around is that I've tried to make it very much like the world is getting back to normal. This is a part of normality. So you'll notice as well that I've cleared up a lot of the crap that was sitting around, apart from that. Okay. There's a clean up everything mod, which again I'll leave the link for you, which just clears up all the stuff. Because I think, you know what, alright, it is post-apocalyptic, but we don't have to live like animals, do we? So I never understood why there'd be little bits of rubble, little bits of rock and stuff around that you couldn't clear up. So I've cleared most of those away. So I think we'll just have a look over here at first. This is the greenhouse. This is where most of the settlers work. So we've got potato plants, mute fruit and corn. Obviously, there are three main products that we produce. And more of the same in here as well in the greenhouse. The reason obviously we produce these is so I can create adhesive for weapon mods and things. So as you see here, I've just put in some little touches like the fermenter bags, the compost bags outside as well. We've got some tools and a hose pipe and things like that. Just thought they're a nice touch really. Around this side as well, like I said, I know what's a brand new truck doing. Basically the options were a completely broken truck or a brand new truck, but again, like I was saying, I wanted this to be a bit more like the world's getting back to normal. So the back of it has got like a motor and a lawnmower. Oh, I need to fix that actually, that's floating. See, like I said, not quite finished here, there's a few details here and there that aren't quite up to standard, but like I said, I just want to show you this before we potentially lose it. Across the road, first thing when you come in, we've got the bar. Oh, shut up, Nick. Yep, thanks. Like I said, we've got the liquor store here and the bar, and there's spare beds as well there. We've got the food and drink menu here, which, you know, you can go inside. We'll just have a quick look inside. So, okay, I think there might be some sort of mapping nav mesh issues here. Jukebox, of course, in a bar. Shop? Anyone? Nope, no one serving. Okay. Here, just got a bit of a kitchen. And a... So again, these are all props that I've put in. You can't pick these up, so they'll stay in place there. You can't knock them over. But yeah, it's just to make the place look more lived in, you know. So like I said, we've got the cash register and some caps and pre-war money and things like that. Again, this is one of the places I need to add some more decoration in, I think. But we've got some beds there. That's sort of the staff bed, if you like. Like I said, there's normally someone serving at the bar here, but I don't quite know where they are. Interesting. Okay, never mind. We'll head across to the General Atomics outlet. I thought that was quite a nice sign. And there should be a spotlight there as well, but it does keep breaking for some reason. I'm not quite sure why. So this is the general goods store. Got the sign outside. A few boxes and things. Again, a price sign. And we'll just head in. Ah, see, there's actually someone here this time. So let us do your repairing. We know how to do it right. So again, this is from a mod. I'll leave the link for you guys. Just loads and loads of different signs that just make the place look so much better. I've got a few bits of knickknacks here and there, just props, just look cool. Another engine, I thought, you know, chuck in some stuff like this, a bit more of a workshop. And here I've got a safe for them as well. A few wooden crates and things. I think we can get the back. Yeah, we can. So this is just sort of the living quarters for the person who runs this store, for the general goods store. Again, needs more decoration. But I've like filled in a lot of the holes in the walls and things. I've sort of like had to glitch those into the wall a bit. And a lovely shiny bathroom. Because again, I mean, people can clean stuff, you know. Why live like animals? We will head now across the road to the guns and armor shop. So yeah, I've just got a few bags out here and a ammo crate. We've got this truck outside as well. Again, I was going to put some power armor in here, just so it looks like it's being transported elsewhere. We can see already into our gun shop. So weapons on the left, armor on the right. Fortunately, we've got some grass coming through the ground there, which is a bit annoying. You can actually close these shutters as well, which is pretty cool. Yeah, and then again, this is the same mod I showed earlier, just all these signs and things, just making the place look a bit more, you know, lived in, like people are actually living and working here. And here I've just got the workshop side of the store. Got a weapons workbench, a weaponsmith bench as well, armorsmith there from mods, obviously. Got some raider armor in the corner that they're working on. And then those guys, they actually live across here. I've assigned them to these beds. Although this guy's in here now. Oh, frame rate just dropped quite a bit there. Got a lot of new people have shown up since I was last in here. Okay. Yeah, so this is just like a little house, basically. Nothing exciting going on here. TV, bedroom and stuff. I didn't fill in these walls. I didn't want to feel like I did in other places. I just felt like some of them should probably... should probably be like still open. Before I forget, we missed out the doctor's surgery, the pharmacy, mega surgery, whatever you want to call it, the clinic. So again, in here we have a doctor. Let's get a look at you.
Not today. Very well.
No, thank you. Okay, so again, just like a few props and things. I guess this guy's just like a patient waiting to go in. Here as well, I've got a couple of surgery rooms, and these chairs actually work as facial reconstruction if you wanted to. So yeah, obviously I can change the bits there and stuff. I won't, because I quite like my character. Glasses back on. Oh, it's just a ward for the doctors and things. Just got some clipboards and bits on the end. That's the doctor's bed. Yes. And that's my tax collector, Red. We'll come back to that later. This is just where they make the chems and stuff, really. Figured, you know, a bit of methylamine in there and wherever else in the crates. So again, I was just trying to decorate this as sort of realistically as possible, if you like. This is the back gate. I believe it's locked at the moment. Yeah, I've locked that using the console. There is a guard meant to be patrolling around here somewhere. I don't quite know where they are at the moment. But who needs guards when you've got one of them bad boys? So, yeah, it's a pretty good field of fire. Now, we'll just head further up the road. Obviously, this is sort of centre of Sanctuary Hills, if you like. This is the house, if you like. But I've sort of decided in my playthrough, my character's too traumatised to go back into the old house there. So it's all boarded up. Doors locked. No one's going in there. So, you know. Across the road, we've got sort of the centre of commerce, if you like. These work tables here. Oh, this is from a mod as well, which again, I'll leave the link. But these guys, this guy will harvest various metals. She'll harvest, you know, I can't remember what she harvests. Over here we have the Undertaker as well, because it's quite a big town. So people are going to die, probably, especially in the wasteland. So, and that generates money. Inside we've got the sort of more bureaucratic officers. So here, tax collector, which will give me more caps. And here we have the postie as well. Hopetent, uniform and everything. It's just an empty room there. Like I said, not quite finished. And that's the bell. I won't ring it. They're all hard at work. We'll just nip across to this side first. Again, I was partway through setting this up as a house. I've just quickly stuck beds in, like you can see. But eventually, the plan is to redecorate all of that. Now, across here, this is where it happens. This is basically where I do a lot of my own crafting. There's a backpack workbench, which is, again, is a mod. Armor workbench in there. Chems and, you know, weaponsmiths, various things. But up here, say, is that a rocket launcher? I can't remember what kind of tower it is, but obviously this is where all the power is. So I kind of figure if raiders are going to attack, they're going to come right up here and have a nice surprise there without pointing straight at them. So yeah, it'll probably destroy my power, but it'll kill them as well. Sort of a kamikaze defense, I guess. This is the back gate. That's supposed to be closed, but okay. You may have noticed that the entire town is walled off. We'll go around the defences properly after this. I just want to show you the buildings inside first. So we've got guns up there to protect. In here, I got as far as buying all the frames by the look of it. Didn't quite finish putting the power armor together, so that's another raider armor I've scavenged from somewhere. With the armorsmith workbench as well, I think once you get certain perks you can create your own power armors with obviously the right materials. So we'll start getting those together. It's T45. Oh, so I've got the full T51 but not the full T45. Don't know how I've managed that, but whatever. So yeah, that was where my power armor is going to be in the various work sheds, if you like. We'll just head down here. I want to head down to the river. So over here, this is where our water supply is. It's well protected, well, as well as it can be. Got a couple of Brahmin troughs here, hence this dude. So, oh, seriously. Okay, so we've got a couple of turrets here. Got a missile turret which covers the bridge for when they attack that way, and of course over there as well. And a spotlight again, which isn't working. And yeah, so that's our water purifier. Now you may be wondering, how does that work? I'll come around here to show you guys. So yeah, I've got like a wire mesh thing. This is sort of like, obviously all the shopkeepers have their own living quarters inside each shop. But this is where this is sort of like the DOS house, if you like. Crafted bunk beds out of these. Unfortunately, NPCs can't actually use these, which is a shame. It took me ages. Don't know how that's happened. That's fallen over. And they all get a duffel bag as well. And then I had to stick some more beds in because I was overpopulated. This is the manor house. This is my personal residence. Now, I apologise in advance because the frame rate is about to go haywire. But in we go. So that's my personal power armor. Oh, that's my T45 power armor. Sorry, I haven't played this save for a while because obviously it's just my building save. Now, like I said, still not furnished. This was going to be the dining area. I was going to have a bit of a living area out here. Up the stairs. And then... balcony. Again, I haven't finished what I was going to do with that. I'm not quite sure what I will do with that. At the moment, it's protecting that part of the wall. And in here is the bedroom. Oh, there goes the frame rate. So this has just got lots of little knickknacks and things in. Yeah, I've got my suit and my trilby and everything in there, just for special occasions. Typewriter and caps, pre-war money and stuff. Again, just a few bits up there, just like a couple of audio files and keys. All my bobbleheads there. And of course the bed, and of course a bit of artwork as well. Again, I still want to put more things on the shelves and things up there and just decorate this house a lot more. Oh god, frame rate really dropped then, didn't it? Okay, so that's all the buildings. Now, I'll take you around and show you the defences. Okay, so we're going to start at this end. This is obviously the main entrance into the town that, you know, if raiders were attacking or whatever, this is the most likely way that they'd come from. Obviously, in terms of weaknesses, this end, they do have a bit of a clear shot on the water purifier, but I don't want to protect that completely. And obviously there is a missile launcher, that turret there, on that side. At night, there's a spotlight covering this area as well. So running along here, you've got the missile launcher that side, and then right above the door, we've got two miniguns, not to mention the guard, who I believe has a sniper rifle. And the big ass door, which closes way too fast in my opinion. The animation's strange. Obviously you've got the big door as well, which will be closed in the event of an attack. Right, we'll just take a little walk along the gangplank now. And again, this is kind of floating. You know, been wanting to put some supports in there, just haven't had time yet. But this mostly goes, quite far around the town. It's entirely walled off and the walkway goes most of the way around. So as you can see, someone firing from here would be rather well protected. So, yeah. And there are guards actually are meant to patrol all along here. Whether they do or not, there are some... sort of navigation issues for NPCs. So here as well, we've got a really good view of everything over there, if you need to be up here. And then this takes us across from the general store over here. Now, you'll notice as well, like, I've redone a lot of the roofs. This kind of roof here, and on the general store as well, and even the bar, they're the easiest ones to do because they're just like pieces that, you know, stick together themselves and stuff. But I wanted a bit of variety about how they've fixed their roofs. So the other version I've done is this. This is obviously using the standard metal roof. And then I've used sort of like mods and glitches and things to be able to position it how I need to. This took ages because when you put one in, I thought it would like then stick at the same angle and it'd be fine. But no, you have to place each one individually. So only a couple of them have this kind of roof at the moment, a couple of the buildings, because they take absolutely ages to do. And as you can see, there's still a hole in it there anyway, so I need to fix that. So from up here we can see we had these two areas that were open. I've left a lot of the hedges in where I can. I've deleted some, and each of those has a turret on of some description. I think they might be laser turrets actually from here. So that's protecting that area. We'll carry on the walkway. So this just goes down to the ground now, because then, like I said, we've got the back gate, the main gate. Again, we've got a minigun, missile launcher. If they were to break through the gate, they'll get this in the back as well. Move further across still, as you can see, all walled off. Here we've got a spotlight as well, which doesn't really make a difference at the moment because we're in morning now. I'm not really sure what that turret is. Might be a rocket launcher. So guards are meant to patrol here. It's quite a good vantage point for anyone attacking from the backside. And these bits are just walled off. I don't know if we can see. I kind of figured these bits are quite steep anyway, and no one would attack up those anyway. May live to regret that. So yeah, again, just all walled off. Jesus. Oh, and one spotlight is actually working. Spotlight up there. So that's glitched on a bit. I think because I was actually building this roof. And then I decided to add this into the end. So like I said, these are the easiest roofs to build. These all just fit together really nicely. And again, that's a really good vantage point for the back gate there, which is protected by a load of turrets. Oh, Nick, why would you open the gate? Just let the enemy in, why don't you? So, yep, there's that. And we'll head round now to the other side of the manor house, where I've got some more protection. Again, this is all walled off, protected, no one can get through there. So there's these walls. I mean, these walls are probably a little bit lower because of the slope. I had to glitch them into the floor. Got the minigun here up on a platform, covering all that area. Same over here, another minigun and also a platform for a guard. So again, another really good vantage point. See the red rocket over there as well. All walled off. We're basically back to the beginning now. There's the missile turret again, covering the bridge. And back to the beginning. So, yeah. That's my Sanctuary Hills, my Sanctuary Fort. Let me know if you liked it. Leave any comments for any improvements you think I can make if I manage to get this save back. Like I said, I just wanted to share this with everyone before I potentially lose it. Okay, thanks very much. I will see you next time on Shenanigames.